In this tutorial, we will start by creating a new assessment. Click on the Create a New Assessment button and then review and close the advisory screen. When you create a new assessment, the tool will automatically populate three fields. The tool enters a default string in the assessment name field. It puts the current date in the assessment date field and includes a generic statement in the executive summary field. Other than the date, all fields contain text strings. The top fields are limited to 100 characters. The descriptive type fields on the bottom of the screen are limited to several thousand characters. However, for practical purposes, these fields should be far larger than needed. The content in the fields should be limited by the amount of information you want on the final reports. Most of the fields are self-explanatory. They capture the location and title of the assessment, as well as the name and contact information of the person who is in charge. The assessment date field requires a valid date in a recognizable format. The tool provides a date picker to help select the date. We begin the process by entering information about the assessment we will be performing. The text for the larger fields like description, comments, and additional context can be prepared and checked in a word processor, and then pasted into these fields, or they can be typed directly in. Remember that you can come back and update this information after the assessment is over, but prior to generating the printed reports. It is recommended that the executive summary text be replaced after the assessment is complete. This summary should ideally capture the important highlights from the analysis information, including strengths and weaknesses, and include planned mitigation actions and follow-up. If the content is concise and limited to several paragraphs, it will fit on the first page of the executive report. You may have noticed on this screen an example of a docking window. In this case, it is the document library. To learn more about how these windows work, go to the docking windows tutorial. Once you have entered the information about the assessment, you can move on to the standard screen by clicking on the Next button or the Standards button on top. This functionality will be described in the next tutorial.